I will never, 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 ever, ever, ever recommend using makeup on a daily, regular basis, because no matter how ugly and disgusting you think you look, you really are not, that is another point, it is not an excuse for you to apply makeup and chemicals and stuff and goop on your face on a regular basis. It's just not right, okay? What you are doing is, you're making your skin worse. If your skin is beautiful, you're destroying it. Having said that, there are those particular days, particular functions, particular someones that we want to look flawless, absolutely perfect for, like once in a while. That now is a totally different ballgame, and it is acceptable, okay? And for that, I'm going to teach you how to apply a foundation. For you to start working on that masterpiece artwork on your face, you need just the perfect right canvas to build your artwork on, okay? Yes, makeup is artwork. I believe in it. You get the right canvas by having just the right base, by clearing out your skin. That is where foundation comes into place. So class, are you ready to start learning about how to build your perfect canvas? A makeup base or a face primer acts as a barrier between your skin and the makeup. So even one of those days when you actually decide to go for the full-faced monkey look, the makeup is not actually harming you as much as it would without the primer. And the primer also helps your makeup go on smoother because it has silicone particles in it, and it kind of fills out your pores and your little bumps and your fine lines if you are old, or if you smile a lot, or maybe if you frown a lot. A makeup base or a primer also makes sure that your makeup lasts longer than it normally would. Contrary to most beliefs, applying a foundation is as easy as drawing a circle. Okay, if you think drawing a circle is not easy, you need help. The only difficult part in applying a foundation is actually getting the right foundation, because there are about 1 million different skin shades in this world, and some company and every company is trying to match some variety of one of those shades. So we have to go and find that one shade that was made for us. Really, foundation shopping is just like getting the right pair of jeans. Now demonstration time. I'm gonna pat on my face. You don't have to think too hoity-toity. You can apply very much with your fingers. Unless you're working on somebody else, then for hygiene reasons, you'll have to go into brushes and all those really fancy gadgets and equipment, okay? Now please don't forget to blend out onto your neck, because you don't want to look like you are going for a masquerade ball. The skin on our face is not as even as we would like it to be. We have different shades of different browns and different pinks and different yellows on different parts of our face. At least, I do. You know, the artistic works. So we use the foundation to actually even out the skin and to make it look like we have one color going on this canvas, okay? Now there is an exception to the order of these steps. If you are using a powder foundation, you conceal first and then the foundation. So whatever that is, liquid or cream, goes on first and then the powder, okay? Now apart from evening out the skin tone, some people need a little extra help to conceal little blemish marks and da-da-da-da under eye circles. Going to go into our concealer, and we're going to conceal all those dirty spots we don't want our love to see. He'll have the shock of his life once you take off your makeup. I'm just gonna go ahead and dab in my concealer under my eye so I can get it all pretty and fool the world into thinking that I've got gorgeous skin. The best way I like applying a concealer is by dabbing away the concealer into your skin. It actually really blends out, see? Now if you have any problem areas on your skin, like I'm just going to say I have a big black spot here, just go ahead and dab it. And blend it out! Now concealer that you're gonna purchase for under the eyes can be one shade lighter than your skin, but everything else, please stick to your skin tone. But if you go 10 shades lighter than your skin, which is what I mostly see, even celebrities do, You're just not gonna look that good because your hands are gonna be black and your face is gonna be white. Not good. Now all of us are just not black or white and different shades of gray, okay? We have an undertone that we need to recognize and work with. There are so many videos on YouTube. Find out what you are and get the right foundation. To set all this work that you've put into your face, which is actually just the beginning of your work, but anyways, to set this, you need to set it with a powder. Just take a little brush, take off my teacher's glasses, tap it, tap it, tap it, tap, and tap off the excess, and just put it on your face. This locks in your foundation, so it's not gonna smudge around and move around. It's gonna stick on that face of yours. And please, don't forget to blend it down. Over here, what we've done is we've taken away all our natural highlights and our contours and our shadings of our face and made it as flat as a paper. So this is why we need to go in for the rest of the makeup routine, okay? Do your homework, class. Go and get the right foundation. But that's it for today. Bye-bye. Number four, you need to know that my handwriting is not really bad, okay? The best way I like if you have oily skin and